Hey, what's up, guys? Sam from RWBY Studios here, back in part 3 of my playthrough of RWBY Grimm Eclipse as Pura. Remember, if you want, you can check in the description below, and if you support me on Patreon, you'll also get a playthrough of this game as me playing through as Blake as well. Those parts are going up at the same time all of the Pura parts are going up. But that's basically all I got for the intro here. So let's get started with... Oh, there's purple flowers!
These doors require a key. Let's look around.
This level's very pretty, although the red grass kind of thing is throwing me off.
Found it.
Oh, found the key already. Okay, never mind. I was going to say, I assume the key would be hidden in these things, but that was super easy. Oh, we can put them in either door. Which one do we want to go through? All right, as Blake, I'm going to go through that door, and as Pura, I'm going to go through the sketchy fucking door. Let's do this shit. Are the doors connected? Oh, no, they're not. Okay. So you can only go one way in this level. I wonder if you eventually have to go back around through the other door. I guess that wouldn't really surprise me. This is my preferred method of travel I've discovered in this game so far. Jump shift. No shit, the music got intense, which means there's gonna be waves of enemies to fight, probably. I forgot how to play. Not gonna lie to you. I think my combo is still left, left, right. Yeah, it is. It's the game says I have upgrades to give Pura. I have new skills, but I don't know if I actually have anything that I want unlocked yet. Considering you have to unlock most of the powers. Anyway, did you check out that jump thing I just did to evade that move? That was really clever and cool. Is there nothing really new here? Let's just ult these guys. Alt still doesn't kill anybody, which is really frustrating. It almost kills them, I guess, but I really thought there'd be a collectible behind that wall. But I feel like the alt should absolutely kill somebody.
Success.
Oh, there was nothing there. So here we go. That'd be really frustrating if this level went full circle and I have to go back the other way eventually with the key. You have to go this way still. Is this like a split path level?
Feels like a puzzle. I love puzzles.
I don't. What the fuck was that? How did I not make that jump? Did I just not time the shift right? Alright, ready?
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
I went through it. Are you kidding me? Okay, ready? Jump shift. Okay, you're not gonna go up that thing, are you?
Because a vision softly creeping.
Here you go, jump, shift. Oh, I went through it again. Okay, that's fun.
Within the sound of silence.
I think I'm just gonna give up and go this way, because this approach isn't working. It doesn't look any different than the other trees, but okay, Pura, sure. Looks magnificent. I didn't hit E fast enough. I'm not very good at hitting the other buttons, because I'm just so determined to be pushing in a specific direction by holding down the WASD. Oh, I did the E thing on the guy who was already one more hit away from being dead. How exciting. We nailed it that time. You fucker. Oh, I'm almost dead. I should probably... Nah, we're good. I can just come... We did it! See, the E move is like a ranged melee attack thing, but it's like... How come those guys died? Were they close enough? I really didn't kill that other one. But anyway, it's like a ranged attack, but most of the people that get stunned so you can use it get stunned after you melee them a bunch. So it's kind of, like, counterintuitive. It seems like you should have, like, a ranged stun for Pura to have an attack like that. But she doesn't. She also doesn't have a juggle, which is endlessly infuriating to me. I would like to be able to juggle things. Oh god, please don't die. I don't want to get frustrated by the puzzle again. Where the game's like, I love puzzles! And then I jump and then shift over to it, and the game just denies me it. There's probably another character I could play as that would have the jump to make it. But I guess Pure is not the one. That is an implication of Blake. Blake can probably make it because he has a really high jump thing. It doesn't go far, though. So that actually might be an issue. Oh, this is probably where the other door goes. Oh, I can jump up here too, though. I'm probably not supposed to jump up here yet, though. I'm probably just supposed to kill this guy who took forever to spawn for whatever reason. Again, another case of this game going, there's waves of enemies here, but we're just not going to put the wave counter up. Because it's technically not an objective. Okay, let's lead everyone around me. Hey guys, because you spawn in groups of four. You're like hunters from Halo, where they spawn in groups of two, but you guys always come in fours, and it's cute. Is my ult regening faster, or is it just because I'm getting better combos? Oh, there's one left. Oh, this guy's bigger, kind of. But he looks identical. I missed the F key again. I suck. One of these days, we're gonna hit a counterattack on somebody. We did it! That's why he's stunned. Funny enough, I don't think Pyrrha has a stun on her own. It's just like part of her abilities. Hey, the door opened after I killed a specific amount of enemies. Almost as if they came in forms of waves. And I took care of the waves. Okay, the exploding guy. Didn't we already establish what they... those look like? Now we know there are more of them. Follow those strange the music. Look at the trees. Why is everything red? Why is this... I always thought it was just like for artsy stuff during the trailer. It was like, because red goes with black very well, and they were doing a thing because Blake is black, and so it was the RWBY Black trailer, but then the red was artsy and stuff, but I guess this is an actual thing in the world of RWBY, where literally everything's just red. I'm not sure how it absorbs sunlight for photosynthesis then, considering the chlorophyll, of which makes plants green, is what... Wow, this is nerdier than just a regular anime game let's play, isn't it now? But science and stuff, and how that doesn't make sense. I mean, I guess some other flowers are different colors, but you know. Green's pretty essential to the things that appear fucking everywhere, such as grass. I need all the help they can get, which isn't this bear. Fuck off, bear. I would shoot you if Pyrrha's ranged attack didn't suck. Like so. Nope, that's T. Look at all that damage it's doing. Look at all of the stuff. Pyrrha's... Also, check out how I'm actually finally hitting an enemy. Boom. I built up my ultimate from this. Oh, I died almost. I thought we died there for a second for some reason. Well, we're about to if I don't react to that. Dodge. Nope, I didn't dodge it. That's unfortunate. But he stuns himself, so. Is this another bear? It is. Oh, you hit me with a rock, you son of a bitch. As soon as you're about to almost attack with stuff, I'm gonna do this. Well, I thought I was going to ult, but it didn't. I should probably just upgrade my ult at this point, right? You know, is there like a RWBY abridged? I say this because I've started to watch a bunch of abridged series lately on YouTube. Those are pretty funny. They used to be way more popular though, but I wonder if you imagine there's probably a RWBY abridged, right? There's probably just not one that's as popular, considering RWBY's already written to be pretty funny and it's a pretty short show too, considering most episodes, especially the first season, are like 5 minutes. So writing an abridged parody of 5 minutes would be like a 3-minute episode, and there would be like two jokes. I guess the later episodes are always at least 14 or so, but still. RWBY episodes in general are always pretty short, which I've never understood. There's always a lot of episodes per season, but I've never understood, like, why not just shorten the episodes in the season, but make the episodes longer? Because obviously, due to budget, you could only have so many minutes per season anyway. I don't know. But I mean, probably if you spread out more videos, you're getting more views, so that's probably their viewing strategy, I guess. I don't know. Someone that works there, who probably understands YouTube better than me, is making the decision. Although I guess RWBY doesn't really air on YouTube as the primary source. Most of its views all come from the website, I would imagine. I'm talking about stuff that literally no one who's watching this video would care about. So let's not talk about YouTube view statistics and stuff. Oh, there's a chess piece here. Is chess a big deal in RWBY? I don't remember it ever being that big of a deal in RWBY. I don't know of anyone who plays it. Maybe I just don't remember. But is there a character who plays? I can only think of, like, carpet. While running along all of this grass, and that it must just feel comfy. Just look at it. Doesn't it feel soft? I can't adjust the camera. It just looks like it would be very soft. Like, the level here looks very soft. Ow, you fucker. Hey, the first wave's complete. I wonder if this thing spins and that area opens over there. And we go underground again. That's a sneaking suspicion of what's about to happen. Actually, it might just not spin. But it'd be cool if it did. Hey, you guys still have health. Okay, so sometimes the alt does kill things at full health. But most of the time it doesn't, and I really don't understand what differentiates that. Is it that they're closer to me, so they take more damage? Or do I need them to be on kind of the outside? I guess we'll have to experiment. I'll just start spamming my alt more, I guess. Implying that I don't already spam it. I feel like Pyrrha should do something with her shield. Is it just me, or does she not seem to do anything with the shield? Maybe is the heavy... Nope, the heavy attack isn't with the shield either. Like, look at this. We don't use the shield at all. Even when you do the counterattack thing, you, like, just stab him harder. I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna hold that. Wait. When you go do the counter-strike thing, you just kick them. What's Pyrrha's shield used for? Not blocking arrows. I didn't hit F again. Oh, there we go. I hit F on that one from a distance away, and then we threw the shield. We did it. Okay, so she used the shield. Thanks. So long-range Counter-Strike things use the shield. I guess she does use her spear like a javelin if you use the E. Kind of. Although I think I acknowledged that in the last video. How you guys doing? There hasn't been any big enemies, so I'm assuming Wave 5 is just a giant bear thing, right? Oh no, it's a giant one of the explodey guys. This is the single player campaign. Whose back are we watching, Pyrrha? Oh, it's cool. I like this one. Ow. Hey, my ult did damage to this guy. Nope. The shield. Pyrrha used the shield. The shield. She should have like a block state where you can just hold down a button for the shield. See, they have a block. Why don't I have a block? Maybe I do. I just don't press it. These guys probably start appearing more often. Ow. They don't do much damage, though. I should actually hit the F button once or twice on this dude. Oh, I tried it there. Didn't do it. I did actually hit it that time, and it didn't do anything. I jumped over the attack I could have countered. I had F on the ready. I had my finger on F. That's why I didn't dodge out of the way of its attack. Because normally I just instinctively tried to dodge rather than hit F. Okay, please stop. I dodged the crystals though. The dust crystal things. I can probably just... There we go.
You're going to have to try harder than that.
Team! That was an incredible display of fighting mastery.
Who's the team? This is the single player campaign.
And more importantly, who's behind it? I sense we're getting close. If you can manage to get to the end of the rail line, we just might find the answer.
Oh, is it this way? Guys, I guess we magically went through the rail? Is this the same level? Do I have to redo the level again, but go a different way? Is that what's happening? No, okay. This is a different chapter. I see where we're at now. Okay, for a second I thought it was the same chapter, because the area is still the same. I assumed we were going underground, but I guess that was not the case. We just magically ended up in the other way of the railroad. Which, technically, the last level 4, which was in part 2, was also just a railroad. Hello. Oh, I should pick on you, because you're the weak one, right? So, I think if you attack them when they're about to stun, it looks like the lower level guys will actually get stunned because they're being attacked. stun animations are important, guys. Nope, not really. Because he just attacked right through it. Oh, there was XP awarded. Yay. Anyway, let's ult through this. I leveled up again. That means we can upgrade something. Although we don't have enough challenges unlocked, really. I guess I can upgrade my alt pool. I'm not really sure what that does, so let's go find out what that does. Okay, without challenges, it looks like I only have two upgrade spaces left, so we'll just grab both of those, and then if I need to respec my character later, then we'll do it. Oh, it basically just means I have two alts, which isn't that bad. I wonder if they charge faster as well. Oh goody. A collectible mission! My favorite. Which is a joke, I actually don't like collectibles. Ever. That looks like the Smash Bros. Symbol, kind of, almost. Looks like in Kirby Air Ride when there was the fake trial things during, what was I talking about? The city trial? No one's gonna get that reference. No one here watching this has ever played Kirby's Air Ride, but that's okay. I enjoyed it. I might do a video in it, eventually. Even though no one's ever played that game because Mario Kart exists, but I enjoyed it, guys. Alright, I have a sneaking suspicion that at the end of this bridge, there's going to be more enemies. Oh, I was wrong. It's just more travel time. Never mind. Are we back at the thing? I feel like we're back. Because I remember the circular table. Oh, I'm almost dead. I should not be almost dead. But I remember the circular table thing. Like, they must just be reusing assets, I guess. Oh, I'm almost dead again. Oh, but I have the aura upgrade. I really wish it would just expand the health bar instead of being a nameless portion of my health bar that's like, hey, do this thing. Or something. So I wouldn't have to guess. I would just know how much health I had. And if it was blinking like this, I would know, like, yo, you're about to die. Instead of just saying, you can survive an arbitrary longer amount without your aura shield thing. I'm just gonna ult you. Fuck you, I have two ults. I don't want to fight a bull. Bulls are annoying, they have a lot of health. It doesn't seem to be... I almost jinxed it and said I almost haven't died yet, but now I'm probably going to die because I said that. Oh well. I died a lot in the first two parts, but I think I'm starting to get the hang of this game, so I'm probably not going to. Maybe, we'll see though. Also, Pure is starting to become leveled up, so... And yeah, this upgrade also makes it so my ult charges faster too, so... That's actually probably just worthwhile. I probably should have just grabbed that upgrade a while ago, rather than putting it off till the, like, basically the last actual upgrade I could get. My fears for a key locating level where there's a lot of backtracking and stuff, I believe have just come true, because now that I have the Smash Bros. Key, does that mean I have to go all the way back to the beginning of the level? Please don't be a long trip back. Okay, no, it's not. It actually did a circle path, so that wasn't too bad. But something tells me that this one isn't going to do the circular path thing, because there's a third door. And this needs to be a challenge. I like that if you twist the camera, the activate words actually go through the door. And the key symbol also shows through the wall. That's kind of funny. Anyway. It's a boat! Guys, let's go sailing.
A shipping port and forever fall.
Team, this discovery is a bit unexpected and worse than I feared. That appears to be an active Merlot Industry ship. But Dr. Merlot hasn't been heard from or seen in ages. I must inform Osmond at once. Meanwhile, I want you to investigate that ship, but please keep a safe distance.
So anyway, let's board the ship. Because that's something reckless teenagers in an anime would do. Guys? Oh, anyway. It keeps referring to a lot of people being in the team, but this is the single-player campaign that I'm doing, so... I'm not sure who's the team everyone's referring to. Maybe you can do the single player campaign co-op, I guess? I didn't actually see any options to invite anybody to the single player game though. So that's a little confusing. I'm not sure. There must be a way though with all that dialogue. Or if the game just wants you to think that, you know, you have your team or whatever. Oh, I used my ult already, so I'm not gonna be able to just kill this guy instantly. I still have some more left. I countered him! Ha! It's actually not that hard to hit the counter strike on enemies if there's just the one. Like this. You just hover your hand over the F key.
We won again. Is that a new record?
That's probably gonna be my new strategy for dealing with one-on-one enemies. This one looks like a sideways exclamation mark. Interesting. I really want to get on the boat, though. I want to be the reckless anime teenager. That sounds like the cool thing to do. Ooh, guys, they're in cages.
Dr. Ublek, this is no ordinary temple.
This temple looks like it's being used as a temporary storage facility for Grimm, of all things. This is quite the discovery.
I wonder if at some point during our travel down to the bottom of this that the cages are going to be opened and all of the Grimm are going to attack me. Oh shit, the exploding guys. There's an artifact! I think I already missed it though because I didn't jump. Oh no, I didn't. We're just gonna do that, I guess. I just bait them into blowing themselves up. Oh, there's waves of enemies now. I wonder at what point we're gonna get more than 10 enemies to appear on screen at once. So I can get that achievement that's like, kill 10 enemies with your ult. That would be cool. But I do need more than 10 enemies to show up at once. It doesn't seem like a campaign wants to do that. Don't you, like, blow up or something? Hey. Blow up. Hey. Ow. Be like, whatever the fuck those things are called in Gears of War, the things that you get up close to and they blow up. I actually forget what they're called. The Lambent. Be like that. Can I chain these together? Look how cool that was. Oh, I'm so cool. I'm so good at the game now. I like that if I just left-click them once, it kind of looks like a bitch slab where I'm just like, blow up. Blow up. Because that's essentially what I'm doing. Hey, what's up, giant bear guy? Well, the ult almost kills this guy now. What? So, okay. So the ult almost kills him, but it doesn't just insta-kill all these little ones? Explain that to me. Is it just percentage-based damage that it does then? Because that seems pretty weird if it's percentage-based damage. Because that would mean it would be more effective on more powerful targets. That could be the case. Hey, blow up. Blow up. They're not doing it, guys. Hey, he did it. Kill yourself. I actually think I had to blow. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. He's following me. I'm already low on health. Please don't follow me. F key's not above his head. F key's not above his head. F key was above his head. I missed. Oh, no. I can't glitch up the wall this time. What the fuck? I didn't press it fast enough. Didn't press it fast enough. I suck. Excuse me, pardon me, excuse me. Yeah, I missed again. You know, I just like... Oh. I dodged your attack and I hit you at the same time. I missed it. Am I not hitting F? Because I for sure tried at that time. Oh, it just doesn't stun him. So F is pretty useless on the bigger guys. Never mind, only use it on the small ones. It's better to just outright dodge this dude. Okay. I say as I get hit by every one of the fucking fury swipes. Settle down, sand slash. It's a shiny slash. It's the sand slash, though. Words are hard, man. I'd say I'm recording this late at night, but honestly, I've destroyed my sleep schedule, so it's really not that late for me anymore. Whoa! It's only like 2 a.m. That's weak stuff now. Can I ult? There we go. You're dead now. Oh wow, you're actually not dead. That's unfortunate. Oh, there's gonna be another one of these guys, isn't there? Yep! It's weird that that attack with the line of dust crystals or whatever the fuck it is doesn't, like, push me back. I can just still be in this dude's face doing damage to him. Ow. As he slices me down into nothing. The best way to not make an enemy... It doesn't even do repeated damage to me. Oh, fuck. But anyway, the best way to make an enemy not seem repetitive really quickly is to, as soon as you introduce them, make you have to fight a fuck ton of them. That's always a good idea. Can you fucking not? F. I did it. It doesn't do anything, though. It stops his attack. But ultimately, it doesn't do that much. Yeah, neither does her ult. What the fuck? To this guy, anyway, in particular. Ow. Ow. Hey. Hey, ow. Oh god, I thought I was gonna die there. That's not the case, though. What the fuck just happened to my game? Why did you do that? Why did you glitch me all the way over here to get hit by this guy? Now I'm all thrown off. I'm off my game. Can I please get a decent ranged attack to deal with this? Nope. Thanks for only hitting me once there, buddy. I didn't really want to do this whole fight over again. I'm glad you understand me. These guys are actually kind of hard to kill. The best part is that F literally does nothing. It just attacks them. I guess it kind of throws him off a little bit, but he still gets a bunch of hits in after. What are you doing? Yeah, see, I hit F there, both times. It didn't really seem to do all that much. Come to me. There you go. Dodge that attack, and then he's always pretty open for stuff after. I'm just gonna ult you, because I want this fight to be over.
You won't be missed. Another victory.
Am I going through the final door? Oh yeah, I think I am going through the final door.
Great job, you made it to the ship.
It's the final door.
We need you to get a closer look to see what kind of cargo they're carrying. But be careful not to be spotted. Who knows what kind of security they have?
Something tells me that they have pet Grimm, so they don't have to. What's in here? So they don't have to animate security guards. But that would just be my assumption. See how I talked like Joel? Guys, my voice acting career is starting soon. I want to be a voice actor. I almost said competitive voice acting career, but...
Team! Where are you?
Wow.
In! Students! Please!
Oh dear. Husband's not going to be happy about this.
What a trap. We literally just walked into that like a mouse trap. Pyrrha was like, guys, check the open container! It didn't even close behind us, which is really funny, because we could have got out at any time, but we wanted to board the ship like reckless teenagers! Awesome! Hey, this level doesn't look like we're boarding a ship. Alright, you guys, that is going to be the end of part 3. I hope you guys are enjoying this series so far. It looks like we are captured now, and we're going to be flying in a ship? Riding in a boat for the next part, hopefully. That would be really cool if it's inside the boat. It's probably not, though. I really want this level to be, though, as I've hyped it up a little bit already. Hope you guys are enjoying the playthrough so far. I think I just said that already, too. This outro is a fucking mess so far. Let me know in the comments below what you think. And also, be sure to check out my Patreon page if you're interested in a Blake playthrough of this game as well. And you can also follow me on Twitter and Twitch. We're finishing up Danganronpa 2 right now as this video is getting uploaded. I think there's only a couple streams left of that, which will that series will also eventually be up on YouTube as well. And I just tweet random things on Twitter, and it's sometimes fun to follow me, because sometimes I'm funny. Occasionally. You can share and subscribe as well, but above all else, you guys, I hope you have a wonderful day. I'll see you around.